Now, we are so lucky to live in a place where it's sunny and 70 most days, but sometimes that comes with a little sunburn. Perhaps many of you have been avoiding doctor visits due to COVID-19, but it's very important for San Diegans to get checked out for skin cancer. Dr. Hugh Greenway with Scripps MD Anderson Cancer Center and Scripps Clinic joins us here this morning to discuss more on this. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Yeah, thanks for being here. Let's talk a little bit about when and how often we should really be getting checked out for skin cancer. I mean, we got a lot of sunny days here.
Well, thank you for having me. Yes, we all love the sunshine. That's one of the reasons we live in San Diego. But we have to remember, even when there's a little cloud, that the sun can still affect us. I think if you're going to live here in San Diego, you probably ought to be checked once a year, either by your dermatologist, your internist, your family physician, and have that exam of your entire skin surface.
But let's just, you know, there's a lot of people at the beach. I see everyone, you know, lathering on the sunscreen and everything. Regardless of how much sunscreen you put on, you still probably need to have that checkup, right?
Right. You still need the checkup if you live here, especially because there are areas of your body you can't see. Most of us don't see our back every day as compared to perhaps our forearm. So you do need to use the regular sun protective measures. You mentioned sunscreen. You need at least a number 30. And they come in all sorts of forms now, in a stick form, a lotion form. We used to be concerned about the spray sunscreens, that they weren't quite as good, but the new spray ones are just as good as the others. So sunscreen, sunglasses are very important. I have a sister who had melanoma of her eye.
Oh,
a hat's important, sun protective clothing. And then be careful, the midday sun is a little more intense. So basically, it's a common sense type approach to protect your skin.
I'm glad the spray works, because my kids, you know, that's the quick way for me to get it on my kids. And speaking of kids, you know, you put it on once and then, you know, we try to, you know, like an hour or so later, try to reapply.
Right.
And they're like, I just put this on. But that's good, right? We need to be reapplying, especially when they're going into the water and everything.
Yeah, they need to reapply. And the other thing I would do with kids is let each kid choose their own sunscreen, because whatever you choose, they're going to want something different.
Totally.
They're more likely to use it and reapply it if they've chosen the one they want. So I'd use, let them do what they want with the type of sunscreen.
That's a great parent tip. I like that. With COVID-19 and the pandemic and everything here, doctor, what have you guys been noticing regarding appointments? Have people been putting those off?
People have been putting those off, you know, through a combination of people being concerned, maybe even afraid, and that's important. I have my docs all read a book on the 1918-1919 flu epidemic, and this is coming along with COVID now, and so people have delayed their appointments. So what we've seen is a delay in that, but still with Scripps MD Anderson, we had a 9% increase in melanoma last year.
Oh.
And we're probably seeing more advanced cases than we should be. So it's very important for you to be checked by your physician.
So those advanced cases are because potentially they didn't, you know, they had an issue, but they weren't addressing it. They didn't get it checked out.
Right. Essentially, they were waiting for the vaccines. They were concerned about being out in public. We do know that at Scripps Clinic and the other facilities in town, that we do take adequate precautions. All the staff are vaccinated. We use all the proper protective measures, including masks in the office. So there's really no reason for patients to be concerned at this point about going into a medical office.
Is there a particular group that may be more at risk, people out there that should really be on the lookout for this?
Well, we know that if you have somebody in your family, I had an aunt die of melanoma, so I'm more at risk. If you have light-colored skin, you have light-colored eyes, you live in San Diego, so that makes us all at risk, especially if we're more into outdoor-type sports. So there are a number of factors that put us at risk. We've seen an increase in melanoma in all groups, but especially in older men in the scalp and forehead, because again, I think of COVID delay. Ladies are more likely to get melanoma on their back and front and lower legs, whereas men, it's more on the torso.
And we can avoid that by wearing hats and glasses. That can help out, especially the older men, because that's been an issue.
Right. One of the big things is with melanoma to avoid a sunburn. If you have a sunburn, then it's more likely to bring on a melanoma either shortly thereafter or years thereafter. So we know that we're all going to be in the sun. We're all going to be exposed, because that's why one of the reasons we're here in San Diego. So the key is to avoid a sunburn and to use the appropriate sun protective measures.
Yeah, we have it up on the screen there. Skin Cancer Awareness Month in May here. Now that we're in the month of May, what do you want people to be thinking about here the rest of this month, Doctor?
Well, we talk about today being Melanoma Monday, and we have different months where we focus on different skin cancers and different cancers overall. And the key with skin cancer, as with any cancer, is early diagnosis. If you see your doctor and they diagnose a melanoma and we get it early, then you have an excellent prognosis. It's probably not going to affect your life. It's going to be more like a word as opposed to a sentence. If you don't get it early, then it's more of a problem. Even though we have lots of new cures, immunotherapies, where we can cure people more and prolong them, but the whole key to any cancer, including skin cancer, is early diagnosis.
Dr. Greenway, thanks so much for your time. You can go to Scripps.org for more information. Thanks again.